Welcome back to the PSB Real Deal in the Ville. We've got the nightcap here on day one. Marcus Burnett joined by Jonathan Hemingway. Nightcap matchup will feature the Indy Lady Gym Rats. Silver BYBL taking on the New York Gaucho. Two great teams set to go head to head. We get ready to bring day one to a close here at PSB Real Deal. Just moments away from tipping off. Gauchos representing the Empire State, obviously. Indy Lady Gym Rats, they're out of the Hoosier State. We still have some coaches that have stuck around. And why would they when you look at the talent that's on the floor? Doesn't take us long to get our first foul of the contest as number two, Shayla Beeler, will head to the free throw line. Amy.
Marcus Beeler taking over the point guard duties. But Dana Evans, being on USA Basketball, out of pocket, so to speak, Beeler steps in. And talking to Coach Riego, was actually very pleased with the way Beeler played the first games of July. A more natural distributor of the basketball. And of course, Dana Evans, leading scorer on the EYBL circuit. Speaking of scoring, Carissa McLaughlin can definitely light it up as she starts this game here with a corner jumper. And that was a three.
So that will make it 3-0.
Yeah, but anytime, Marcus, that you lose, the leading scorer, not only of your team, but of an entire league, you think that, there would be a little bit of a drop off. But you see right here, Beeler stepping in, just a 2019 prospect. And, there's going to be a drop off, so to speak. But, she's certainly making a seamless, transition in many ways.
Jim Moore said playoffs. Beeler says drop off. No drop off right here. McLaughlin with the hesitation move. Chose to get a piece of it. Now coming the other way, we'll see who that was last touched by. Looks like it goes off the hands of Rebecca Ripley. So it'll go back to the Lady Gym Rats. But again, obviously, Dana Evans, that type of production, the numbers she's putting up, what she brings to the team. Beeler just being herself, getting better. Very realistic and self-aware perspective by Danny Riego talking with him prior to the game in terms of doesn't have to be Dana Evans. Just be herself, get others involved, but also do what she can do individually. And you mentioned McLaughlin. That stroke speaks for herself.
Coach Amanda Butler sitting on the front row watching her future Gator. Carissa McLaughlin here with another three-point shot. McLaughlin gave her a verbal commitment to Butler and the Gators last year, and Coach Butler has to like what she sees right now. And speaking of liking what you see, Rebecca Ripley hits that three, and assistant coach from Miami, Octavia Blue, on the back row watching Ripley, as Ripley is a University of Miami commit. Marcus, we had a chance to watch Ripley and the Lady Chose at PSB Tip-Off Classic. We got a sense of her game, had a solid showing up there, and she's picking up where she left off here at the Real Deal.
Trying to attack the offensive glass there. Gym Rats in good position. They get the ball. They have a six-point advantage. Beeler kicks it to the corner. McLaughlin.
Such a hard action to guard right there. And one of the things I like about Riego and his offense is you see transition lay in there by number 23, Selena Filoxi. they do such a great job of setting up the ball screen and setting the ball screen at different angles. You know, too many times that high ball screen is only set, you know, with the players, you know, shoulders to the sideline. The possession before, we saw Beeler, you know, set it up, then cross over. The screener changes the angle, gets downhill, forces the help to commit, kicks to the shooter in the corner. A great understanding, and we talked a little bit about it in our first broadcast, but that's what the Gym Rats, you know, bring, is a next level understanding of what the game of basketball is all about. You know, more than just running a set, you know, running some sort of continuity, but instead giving them ideas and principles that are going to translate to the next level.
Robin touches base with Coach Riego. Free throws off the mark. And what's great about this lineup and you know, these tournaments in July is that three-pointer is knocked down by Shea Corby. That's Sahai Corby.
Good passing right here.
One of the things that I love is for every good coach, good program, you've got another one that's going head-to-head against it. You talk about the Gauchos program, their history, the pipeline of talent that they always bring to the table, and a solid head coach there in Earl Elliott. Nasia Clark also there as assistant coach.
I agree with you for sure. I mean, when you mention or use the word program, you know, that implies that it's more than just a one-year thing. You know, there's a lot of teams, you know, that show up for a year and then they dissipate after, you know, 12 or 24 months. Both of these organizations have been around for years. Riego and Elliott both they've been up and down, you know, the ladder of travel basketball, so they understand what it takes to be successful.
Having what it takes to score on that play was number 21, Ellen Ross.
Ross, just a 2019 prospect. Good size on her, 5'11", using her size on the interior. But using her shooting stroke from the exterior is Corby once again with a three.
McLaughlin catch and shoot, ice cream, mid-range.
That's a pretty shot, isn't it? Such a compact release. The footwork.
Take a look at a couple of these scores here early on. That's McLaughlin, that's way too much space.
What I like about that is shooting pockets high. Her release is high. You know, I call that a very efficient, you know, release. It's a release that can be replicable.
Speaking of replicable, Rebecca Ripley ripping that one from the corner.
Boy, that's a quartet of ours right there.
Yeah, it was, man.
Rebecca Ripley, replicable. Ripping the nets. I like it.
Hooked on Phonics will be proud of that last little sequence. And then last but definitely not least, you see that splash there by Corby.
We talked about it in our first broadcast of the day, but PSB Real Deal 1, not a tourney format, pure showcase. You know, many of these teams are gearing up for a tournament the last 3 days of the first part of July. You know, the big tournaments at the beginning and the end. So this is kind of a way to stay sharp in between. And we mentioned Ripley just a moment ago. She's going with her offhand this time off the drive to finish there to tie it up at 13.
Good shot. Score for Ross. It's great. That's just one of those awareness and muscle memory shots. Ross knew where she was at. As soon as she caught that one, just able to release it and knock it down.
Good defense right there by Carissa. It's real easy to try to. You see Falaxi right there with a nice mid-range. McLaughlin really hedged out and flattened out the drive. McLaughlin is one of the elite shooters in the class of 2017. You see Beeler getting downhill. And it would be really easy just to classify McLaughlin as a shooter only. Fact of the matter is that kid can play basketball. She's a basketball player. Pay attention to her game on the defensive end, plays real heady and smart. And, you know, to the casual observer, you say, well, you know, she's not blocking shots. She's not making a bunch of steals. You know, not real flashy, but being a good defender is more than, you know, those tangible stats. But instead, you know, it's about position defense. Are you preventing, you know, your player from, you know, getting easy shots? And then on the offensive end, what's impressed me about McLaughlin is her ability to move without the basketball. She's running off of screens. You know, she's finding the open area. A very well-rounded shooting guard. And I think she's going to have, you know, a long, successful career in the SEC.
2-point game now. All over that pass. The layup drill on the other end by Beeler. As Biloxi gave that one up, and Beeler was, she didn't even have to jump the passing lane, just kept her hands there and got it. Nice job attacking by Biloxi. Good things have happened when she's had the ball in her hands the past few times. She scored on the jumper. The last time, she kind of forced a pass. She had that open look and some room to work with right there at that free throw line area again. And there you see her drive. She misses the shot, but she's showing you what she can do if she can just get right there at the free throw line and just read the situation.
You know, they play her at the five position as you see Ariel Scott getting into the action right here with the jumper. Ariel recently transferred down to the Champaign-Urbana area, going to go to Urbana High School. Right there in Fighting Illini territory. I believe she's got an offer from the Illini, as well as a number of other Big Ten schools. But to finish our previous thought there about Selena, they play her at the center position, but you know, she's a real versatile, you know, kind of a combo post player. Scott gets another one to go right here. And she presents mismatch opportunities because she can step out to the perimeter, take kids off of the dribble, as well as score in the paint.
Five to 15, a little flurry of triples. Has helped the Lady Gymrats take a lead, and they're showing off some versatility. Sydney Dodd out of Warren Central.
You know, just a moment ago, this was a 15-15 game, maybe 17-15 game. And suddenly it's now a 12-point game. And what's interesting about this is it's come from a number of different places, you know. Speaking of the Gymrats, Dodd's been in there. McLaughlin's hit a couple. Scott's hit a couple. Beeler's gotten downhill, so. A little late whistle right there by our man.
That was gonna be interesting because the Gauchos, their team that's there watching as well as the coach, they were ready to go crazy if that one wasn't called, and I don't blame them. If you even look at Ellen Ross, she was kind of like, well, I mean, I'll just flip it up there. I haven't heard a whistle yet, so I'm just going to flip it up there and see if it sticks. They called the travel, so a 12-point game. Gauchos with it. Final second.
Good defense. Really good defense.
So that will do it for the first quarter. Appreciate you joining us here on SUV TV. We'll be right back with more PSB Real Deal in the Ville. And welcome back here to Wilson Central High School here in Lebanon, Tennessee, just outside of Nashville as we get the second half going. Nice way to start if you're the Lady Choles. Rebecca Ripley continues to play well as they try to cut this gap.
She's been a bright spot for the Choles. Several threes. Philoxi has also been a bright spot, but the Gym Rats have brought a balanced scoring attack. And we were talking about a moment ago the value of these showcase games, you know, leading up before the bigger tournaments. You know, at the end of the break, gives opportunities for, you know, Coach Riego, you know, to play kids on his bench that sometimes don't get as many minutes. And also to kind of work out, you know, some wrinkles, you know, for some newer pieces, such as Beeler,
who feeds it inside to Dodd, and Dodd does the rest.
You know, Beeler, you know, taking over point guard duties for Evans. You know, so for an EYBL team like the Gym Rats, it's going to be important for them to figure out the roles, to figure out how Beeler plays. And right now, it looks like they're hitting on all cylinders.
We'll have a trip to the line coming for Philoxi.
The young man down there, he's got to get his whistle a little stronger.
say it with your chest.
Yeah, right?
Rico makes an 18-29 substitution in for the Choles. Isaiah Morgan, number two. As Corby gets a breather. So 19-29. It's a 10-point game. Miller hands it off to McLaughlin. McLaughlin was looking for Dodd. That hole closed. Turning the corner, too strong off the glass there as McLaughlin rebounds. Going to be brought the other way by Morgan. Morgan over to Ripley. Ripley has been the pick to click here so far. Okay. Nice little move along the baseline. As good of a move as it was, Beeler stuck with it. As Sidney Dodd says, excuse me, this ball's mine. Wrestles it away. McLaughlin gets it ahead. Back to McLaughlin. Three-pointer on the way, in and out. Just like what we're seeing here, man, in terms of his quality. The quality of play by the players. You see a nice move along the baseline there by Ripley. But Beal are able to be right there and recover.
Look at that pass.
Great entry pass. Dodd bothered, though, by that Lady Choles defense. Good job of bothering that shot. Now here's Deanna Davis, who I look to be a little bit more aggressive over the next couple minutes. So you've seen Ripley, you've seen Philoxi.
I think you got to give, I'm sorry, Marcus.
No,
you're talking about, you know, Davis, you know, hoping that she could, you know, get things going. But I think you got to give a lot of credit to the Gym Rats' perimeter defense. Their guards have done a terrific job. Beeler, McLaughlin, both moving their feet, not reaching, not gambling. And a kid like Davis, she likes to hit the gaps and get downhill, and they've closed those gaps up pretty strongly.
Agreed. Plenty of time left. Choles just hovering it right around that 10-point deficit, but you know a run is coming for the New York Gauchos at some point. Pass inside to Dodd, poked away by Philoxi. Philoxi running the floor, pass a little bit too far ahead there.
There's a perfect example when it comes to post play. As a post player, you want to maintain that contact versus the defense. You release that contact. Now you open up the defense to be able to shoot the gap. And more importantly, from a defensive perspective, avoiding that contact allows you the ability to get those steals and deflections.
Ripley didn't protect the ball on that rebound. It was wrestled away by Howard Bass. Baylor being guarded by the speedy Morgan. Ball stripped away, good hands. Didn't see exactly who was able to get a hand on it. Davis chases it down and is able to keep it in bounds. She's calling for it in the corner. Pretty good look. Can't get the shot to go for Luxie with the rebound and the lay-in.
Bowles has got it. Speaking of maintaining contact there, Bowles has got to make contact on that rebound. She had position, but for Luxie, just a little quicker to the basketball, gets the putback.
And it's now an eight-point game. Stepping through tough. Is McLaughlin, kiss off the window.
Tough step through. Come on, Marcus.
McLaughlin, man, getting it done in multiple levels. And again, she sets up a lot of the moves that she makes with the ability to catch and shoot well.
No doubt.
Wide open look. That's a good look there for Kirsten Moore. I don't think she'll miss too many of those with that much space. Foul called on the play. Let's take another look at that last move by McLaughlin. See her step through, protect the ball. And get that one over the outstretched arm of Philoxy. Second free throw is good. 33-21. Oh, 335 and counting. Good kick. Shot knocked down by Kirsten Moore.
Well, you called it. You said if she continues to get open looks, she's going to be able to, she's going to knock some down, and that's exactly what she did there.
I haven't seen a ton of Kirsten Moore, but I know enough to know, you know, so many times, aside from doing your homework, the coach's body language when a player takes a certain shot or their verbals, they let you know what's going on. And Coach Earl Elliott, when she took that last shot, even though she missed it, he was saying bang, bang before it left her hand. So you put two and two together, you know she's a capable shooter. Coast to coast, the finish. Coach Elliott wanted the foul. They don't call one. But it's a bucket there by Selena Philoxy. The Jim Rutz ball there along the baseline, 2 minutes, 46 seconds. And counting. Sydney Dodge is on the bench now. Number 32, Brianna Bowles has come in, and McLaughlin, another triple. Another good look for Kirsten Moore. Can't get the shot to go. Take a look at the last one knocked down by Moore again. Philoxy continuing to be aggressive even when she's not scoring it. Able to create some opportunities for others. First time we saw an assist to Moore, probably won't be the last. With the high level of activity we've seen from Philoxy, she'll get a breather. She's on the bench. Deanna Davis. Makes slight work there on the fast break. Lays it in to make it a 9-point game.
Starting to feel something here with the Chos. Momentum definitely in their favor right now.
Bowles trying to set up on the inside against Charlotte Lewis. They kick it out to McLaughlin. Layup.
So much for that momentum, man. That's tough.
And the Gauchos have gotten better defensively as the game has went on. McLaughlin with just such a quick release. And she's not just a one-trick pony in terms of just shooting a bunch of jump shots. She's kind of made them respect the drive, but there, Deanna Davis, you knew she would get going at some point. Didn't force it early on, just sort of let the game come to her. Really got Filoxi involved. Well, you've seen her get the last two buckets for the Gauchos as we come up under the final minute. McLaughlin gets the step and the lay-in. Keep giving Moore that open shot. So that one gets stuck. They get the ball unstuck. Take a look at that last finish there by Deanna Davis. Cradles it with the right. Kicks it to the left there for a nice touch on the lane. Lead is now 12 for the Lady Gymrats. Foul on the floor as Morgan drives. Selena Filoxi checking back in for Charlotte Lewis.
Number of high-profile coaches in the building here today. Head coaches from Toledo and Indiana sitting on the back line, as well as Amanda Butler from Florida. Assistants from Georgia, Rutgers, Tennessee, Wake Forest, East Carolina. Great evaluation and exposure opportunity for these young ladies.
Taking full advantage of it. She's already committed, but at this point, all about getting better. Carissa McLaughlin making it happen here at PSB Real Deal in DeVille. We'll be back after halftime. move on into the third quarter. And yes, it is the third quarter. That's not deja vu, as it was in the first half. That is Carissa McLaughlin knocking down yet another triple. She tries to get the Gym Rats off to a good start here in the second half. 15-point advantage. Philoxy also had a good first half for the Gauchos, although they weren't able to close the gap, showed signs of making a run. It's just every time that they did, the Lady Gym Rats were able to get the buckets that they needed to make sure it's hovered right around to a 10-plus point advantage for most of this contest. Marcus Burnett joined by J.O. Hemingway, Deanna Davis all over the passing lanes there. Couldn't keep it in bounds, so it'll go over to the stay with the Gym Rats. Dot calling for it.
Carissa McLaughlin, filthy shooter, man. I mean, filthy and clean all at the same time, if that makes sense.
Yeah, getting it done, man.
Yeah.
Beeler with the nice read, stops Pops for the mid-range J, makes it a 17-point advantage. Biloxi looking to go to work against Dodd. Made a nice move, couldn't get the shot to go. Biller over to McLaughlin, trying to find the hot hand. McLaughlin off the mark, rebound brought down by Kirsten Moore. If I'm the Gauchos, I'd like for, you know, Deanna Davis, she got better as the half went on. Need her and Biloxi continuing to attack, setting up shots for the knockdown shooter in Kirsten Moore. Also Rebecca Ripley. You see Ripley creating off the dribble there, but it's better off the catch and shoot in the first half. More than capable of doing that off the dribble, but the Gauchos' success on the offensive end in this particular game has come with Philoxy and Davis in attack mode as Ripley knocks that one out of play.
Gym Rats starting to stretch this lead out a little bit here. Now it's up to 17. We're just a couple of minutes into this third quarter. Coach Riego and Coach Stevens have to be feeling pretty good about how this team is shaping up, heading into their final EYBL stop here within the next 2 days.
Contact there is going to send Ripley to the free throw line.
You know, Ripley had a good showing back in April at PSB Tip-Off Classic, but I can say that she looks, you know, even better here tonight. Playing with a lot more confidence, shooting the ball well, attacking the rim in transition.
She makes it a 15-point game there at the free throw line, getting back and swatting that one out of bounds. Is Philoxy. Be thrown in by Beeler. Good defense by the Gauchos, suffocating there along the baseline. They knock another one out of bounds. Beeler has it in the corner, now being guarded by Ripley. Surprised they didn't switch there on that one and put Davis on Beeler. Have Ripley go ahead and go out to Ariel Scott, but it all worked out. They get the stop. Good defensive sequence there. Baseline drive by Philoxy. She'll go to the line. Like what we're seeing between her and Doc, going at it. I'm going to help you back up, and then we're going to go at it again.
Yep.
Two players going hard.
You know, this matchup between Philoxy and Dodd. Dodd has the advantage, you know, on the block, the size, the strength to be able to push Philoxy out of her area. Now Philoxy can stretch her out and use her quick first step to get to the line or get to the rim, draw fouls, get to the line.
And then for Phylloxi, it's, yeah, you know, Dodd has that strength advantage, but if Phylloxi can still make sure she has a little bit more of a distance from the goal, she has enough strength to make it a, you know, to make it a difficult shot. Now once she, now once Dodd gets too low, you know, you can cancel Christmas, but Phylloxi has enough strength to still be a contender down there in the post.
It's a good matchup. I mean, neither are, you know, deficient in any one area. I mean, even though Dodd is, she's a big girl, but she's got good enough feet to be able to move laterally, you know, sufficiently. But Phylloxi just has enough of a first step to, you know, give herself an advantage. So, there are different types of players, but it's good bump, you know, with both of them going at each other.
Lead now 14 for the Lady Gymrats. Is Davis, guarded by Bill. Baylor going for a five count. Davis had got past her, but Baylor not giving up. Nice job of sticking with it. Davis with the assist and the lay-in by Kirsten Moore.
Moore went over 1,000 points this year as a high school basketball player. And she's not going to get to close to 1,000 here tonight, but she is putting up quite a few here in this game.
I think she has more to put in. She's had some jumpers that were right on line, on target, just wouldn't stay down for her. She's going to be a key part of any Lady Gauchos run to close this gap here in the second half.
Ellen Ross with another lay-in on the opposite side, but right back at you here. Selena Phylloxi with the drive, the Draymond kick, or the Draymond Green kick out. Okay.
Tough shot there.
Yeah. And the and one completes the three-point play. See, Draymond didn't need to kick his leg out that far. I mean, that was clear exaggeration, right?
Yeah. Yeah. And he paid for it because that one's knocked down there by Malia Howard Bass. He doesn't have to sit game five in that Cleveland series if he didn't have those previous strikes against his record.
Yep.
Not to say Cleveland wouldn't have won it if he had played, but I mean, you're not trying to put an asterisk by what they did, but you know, he's a factor not to have in a potential clincher. Howard Bass. Chance to get back-to-back threes. This time it bounces. As she celebrates it going back down on the other end of the floor.
A little headband started falling off midway through the shot, and you can kind of see her react to it a little bit, and the shot still went in. That's why she was so excited. Like this kid. She plays with a lot of heart, a lot of spunk, something different about Howard Bass.
Shot off the mark, offensive rebound. That one's blocked out of there by Phylloxi. Checking in for the Gauchos, number 10, Danielle Robinson, as she's going to give Rebecca Ripley a breather. McLaughlin tries to go inside. Had positioning there against Corby. Going to get that one to go off the glass. If you're the Gauchos, it would be good if you could get this down to 10 to 12 points before you end this third quarter. It would make it a much more manageable hump to be able to bring down. Sticking with the play, yes, Phylloxi saves it right to Davis for the lay-in. He's down to 15 now. Ball screen coming here. Howard Bass this time, it's a two.
Too many shooters on this team, huh?
do a good job of being aggressive there on the ball screen coming for McLaughlin. You don't really let her get any space. And then Howard Bass makes a play.
That's where as a shooter, you got to develop that one dribble pull up. Speaking of one dribble pull ups for Lux, he gets it right there in the lane. But Howard Bass, a previous possession, she catches it on the arc. The defense closes out hard. Put her on the deck one time, pull up.
They get a piece of it inside. Faluxy pulls it out of there. And the Gauchos are running. Faluxy's focused. Bucket and one. No, they call an offensive foul. That's a tough one right there.
It's a tough one.
Let's take a look at that one. Faluxy's coming through. Oh, that's a tough call to make because it did look like she might have gotten those feet set at the last second.
Yeah. Charge block.
Could see it going either way. It wasn't definitive for us, and we were able to slow it down and look at it. Yeah. So for the ref to have to make that call during game speed.
And there's no circle.
Yeah.
And there's no circle, right. You know, like there is in college. So he made his call. Meanwhile, you got to live with it.
Meanwhile, I like what we've seen from Selena Faluxy. That jumper a couple minutes ago there just inside the elbow. She's showing what she can do in front of these college coaches here today. I want to look at that charge play again. Very good footwork by Howard Bass because I thought she was moving. Actually, when I look at that again, I think that should have been a blocking foul.
She was kind of leaning back, but like you say, you have the advantage of being able to slow it down here on the replay. So
you can see why the official missed it, but she sped her feet up to where even though she was still moving by the time that Faluxy went airborne, she was still able to sell it. So 41-56. 15-point game, pass to Beeler. Beeler misses the shot. Kirsten Moore with the rebound. Can't get it up in time. But we end the third quarter. We'll go into the fourth. It's a 15-point game. The Gauchos trying to close the gap. We'll see what they can do in the fourth. Welcome back as we are seconds away from getting the fourth quarter started. Marcus Burnett joined on the mic by Brandon Clay. Gauchos, Lady Gym Rats, day one of PSB Real Deal in the Ville. Life's good, Brandon.
It's so real, it seems fake. You know, it's been great. When you talk about the opening night here and you look at the last game of the night and you've got, you know, Florida head coach Amanda Butler, Dean Lockwood, Tennessee, Indiana coach Terry Moore, Toledo coach Trisha Cullip. I mean, multiple Power Five head coaches and or influence makers there. And then some of your top mid-majors in the country, too, in East Carolina in the building. Wake Forest still in the building. Miami, you name it, and they're in here. And gives you a reason to keep competing as you see that basket right there, even when you're down.
That's Kirsten Moore. Moore has done some scoring throughout this game, but I still think her better minutes are ahead of her as she tries to get going in the fourth. Ariel Scott one of the hands on deck for this Gym Rats team that just looks like they're having fun out there.
Ariel Scott's one of the coolest kids I've ever been around. Like, nothing really phases her often, you know, especially when she's in a rhythm like that. The ball was halfway to the rim, and she turned around, was running the other way, and pointing to Beeler for the assist already. You know, she's just a special kid in that regard. And I'm interested to see what Beeler is able to do this summer at the point for the Gym Rats and Dana Evans' spot as she's out playing with the U18 team right now, USA Basketball.
It's a good move on the Gauchos in by Charlotte Lures. A nice little reverse, but the Gym Rats answer right back and in a tough spot because if you're the Gauchos, you're trying to make a run. You can't really afford to trade buckets for the Gym Rats, but it's easier said than done when it comes to stopping them from scoring.
No question. That's just a great finish there by Ross. I like the flat ball screen action that, you know, Coach Elliott's getting for the Gauchos. When we talk about industry veterans, Danny Rigo and Earl Elliott, it doesn't get much better than the two of those guys in terms of taking players and getting them to play inside and into their roles, man. Fantastic.
Beeler will bring it across. The discussion topic was, as you mentioned, Dana Evans playing with Team USA. Beeler having to be brought up into that spot.
Yeah, she's going to do a fantastic job, man. Distributor. Yeah. Tempo changer, tempo pusher, similar frame to Evans, but a little bit different style of game. Evans is definitely a kid that likes to score and can put the ball in the bucket in addition to making people better. Where I feel like Beeler is a kid that really wants to distribute the basketball first in addition to being able to score.
First free throw off the front of the rim there for Lures. A miss, but the offensive rebound there by Shanice Graves. So Graves gives them another look at it. Rebecca Ribley had a hot start. She got a couple buckets here in the second half. They need her to get going here in the fourth. Good defense by Beeler. But another offensive rebound for the Gauchos. Now they work it inside to Lures. Lures, some contact on the play, no foul call.
Hey, end of the day, that's a big joker there, man. And then they get it right back. You know, the no call there, but then maybe a couple extra steps. They let it go, and we're back to playing, man. That's going in. Oh, she didn't miss many of those, man.
Gauchos doing a great job on the offensive glass. Coach Elliott gets a timeout. They really want to take advantage of this possession here. They can make it a 14-point game. Or a 13-point game if Ripley, Kirsten Moore, and company can knock down a triple. We'll see how they do out of this timeout. Coming up on the 5-minute mark. It's a 14-point game. New York trying to make a run here. McLaughlin sets the screen.
That's a great move there off the bounce. Looks similar. You remember we talked about that move she made on Memorial Day weekend when she got down the baseline. Didn't need the hesitation bounce there, but her willingness to attack, that's something new that we're seeing in her game this summer.
That jump shot to set some of those moves up nicely as Beeler gets it to her. Catch and shoot. Shot off the mark. Big rebound there by Ripley. Now the Gauchos looking to run. Ripley going to keep it. Can't get the layup to go. Good defense. Great energy off the bench for Shanice Graves. She's come in, got a couple key steals and rebounds here over the past few minutes. Biloxi leaves that one just short. She's been playing hard all game.
Thing going back and forth, man. Looking like a quality game of table tennis, not ping pong. Jonathan Hemingway voice.
Biloxi with the rebound and the lay-in. So the 14-point gap is cut down to 12.
Well, the Gauchos have done a good job. The game definitely is at a pace that they like to play. And they've done a good job in the half court of isolating, getting the ball into their post play. They just haven't been able to finish a couple of shots down low, but it's been a good quality game in terms of what Earl Elliott and his staff want to do. They just got to convert a little bit more on the inside.
So they've got 3 minutes, 38 seconds to work with. Stranger things have happened.
No question. Especially around here, man. When you start talking about these teams that play at this level, anything under 20 isn't safe, man. Anything under 20 is not safe.
Take a look at Coach Elliott talking to his Gauchos, and then over on the other side, you know, you mentioned the coaching track records of both these coaches, and Danny Riego and Earl Elliott.
Well, and you look at, I mean, you know, even down to the staffs for them, man, you know, whether it's Will Rampersant, whether it's Mark Stevens here on the gym rat bench, you know, these guys all coach all the teams. You know, so Mark is the head coach of the gold team. Will really works with the freshmen and the sophomores, but they coach all the teams. All these kids are program kids as opposed to being members of one team or the other. That's what allows such fluid transition from team to team. Beeler was with the gold team a little earlier this summer. After Evans got picked up, she ends up moving to the silver team.
Dodd with a big offensive rebound. Biloxi battling in there, couldn't come up with it. Good active hands as Deanna Davis and Biloxi converge to strip that one away.
Oh, great move. Ooh, everything but the finish, but you love the attack. And that, look at that. Still attacking on D. They just are struggling to put the basketball in the hole.
That brings new meaning to the phrase, catch it or wear it.
Whoa.
As that one had a lot of mustard on it, pass intended for Ripley.
Hey, that thing came in there like an old school Brett Favre slant, man. Quick 5 to 7 yard. You got to get your hands up, Chief. When you see Ellen Ross and Dodd that just checked out, I want to make sure we touch both of them. Ross can play. You saw some of the footwork earlier, just 2019. Kid that will be in the program pipeline for a second. And then Dodd, same thing there. So a couple of younger kids. You know, Riego always has some youth in the pipeline, youth in the movement, but this particular roster a little bit different than even ones that he's coached before, where there's a lot of youth, even 3 years down, kids that could potentially play for silver for 3 years.
Strong move by Ripley. The finish pulls them to within 10.
That's one of those you finish in your body, weight room. You know, there's some kind of ad-lib call there after that one, Marcus.
That's what that little subtle tap to the player waiting to inbound the ball. That was their way of saying it. McLaughlin, Ripley got a piece of it. Ooh. Watched another one away. Does Ripley. Deanna Davis has a player ahead. It's Kirsten Moore with the layup.
Boy, and you, like I said, the energy's been there the whole time. It's not been a lack of effort. It's just been the fact they haven't been able to execute some of these close shots. Ripley with the bump and the finish, great play defensively, and then they come back and get another basket in transition as a result of Ripley's defense.
And we've got an 8-point game here, under 2 minutes left. On the drive.
Oh, great read.
Howard Bass for three. Timely response there as Bass knocks it down.
What a great pitch from Scott. And then, like you said, the ability from Howard Bass to actually make the open shot once she gets it. But Scott reading two defenders on her, doesn't try to force the issue, kicks it out. Now it's a double-digit lead. And it's that's a deflating shot if you're the Gauchos. You've made progress, and then you watch that one go in on what was a quality defensive sequence, but just better offense.
Take another look at Ripley's bucket from a couple minutes ago. Strong drive on that one, 11-point lead. At 1 minute, 35 seconds remaining in the contest. The Lady Gauchos trying to make it happen. So Brandon, when you look at this reset, 53-64, minute 35 left. Your thoughts?
But when you talk about the Gauchos, Mark, from what they bring to the table, their calling card is energy. They've got to find a way to get stops, get baskets, make positive things happen.
Davis to Filoxi. She's been able to make things happen this whole game. She tries spinning, gets caught up a little bit. Now still working inside.
Great defense by Bowles on the interior to have a hand up and contest that shot without fouling and sending it to the line. Oh, great pass.
Able to get a hand on it was Kirsten Moore. Ripley is tripped up, trying to keep a hand on it. And she gets a timeout. Our Coach Elliott steps in and gets that timeout just in the nick of time.
Oh, great hustle both sides. When you talk about kids that are playing hard, whether it's a Filoxi around the rim, that's what she's going to sleep well tonight. I don't know a lot, but she's going to sleep well tonight the way she's played. Bowles with the interior defense, Scott on the floor, Ripley on the floor. You know, Ripley's a kid already going to Miami. Octavia Blue in the building tonight watching her play. Good basketball here.
1:10 here on the game clock. And this has been a hard few minutes, a hard-fought few minutes. Like you mentioned, no lack of effort on the Gaucho side of things. They had feverish stretches where they were able to get steals, get turnovers, were in attack mode, shots just wouldn't fall. But here they are trying to make things happen within this final minute and 10 seconds.
And doing a great job at that. Like I said, getting into and attacking the defense. As you see, another opportunity there, and they finished it. They've gotten no shots the entire second half. It's just a matter of converting.
Ripley converts to make it a 9-point game, deep three-pointer.
Oh, wow. We call those backbreakers, man, when you're really feeling it. She was really feeling that. She was about 23, 24 feet away. Look at Ripley hustling just everywhere. Bowles looks like, what more can I do? I put the ball off the glass like I was supposed to. Ball rolls around the rim and just literally doesn't go in.
Here the Gauchos got to, you see that deep shot trickle in, come out, unable to get the rebound. But getting the steal there is Ripley. Ripley with the lay-in.
She's such a competitor in a gamer, man. Loved her at the PSB Tip-Off Classic in the spring. Back that first April weekend. Look at Filoxi. This is exactly what I'm talking about. Like, you talk about a kid that doesn't quit and just plays. Her and Ripley together are a heck of a tandem. Yes. They are literally always around the basketball.
That they are. They came very close to forcing a jump ball there prior to the foul being called. A foul builder. It's really been go time for Rebecca Ripley over the past few minutes. You're going to see her.
That's just getting big right there. You know, we talked about that weight room, and you see it all through Ripley's shoulders. Real strength.
So 1-1. So we'll have free throws coming here on the 1-1 opportunity for Ariel Scott.
Well, in a clarification for that, we played the NBA style rule there. Second team foul under 2 minutes, an automatic 1-1. Honestly, we put that in so that when teams are fouling late, trying to get from 3 fouls to 10 fouls, we don't get anybody hurt. That's the last thing we want. 2 quick fouls and you're on the line, but that actually applies in this case here.
Watch out, go get it, 7-point game. Now an 8-point game after the first free throw. It's knocked down. Only 2 5/10 of a second remain. business as usual. Trip to the free throw line there for Scott. Now it's in the hands of Deanna Davis. Davis to Filoxi. They don't have a ton of time to work with. Filoxi feels like it's go time. Strong
just,
take.
Just attacks, man. Just attacks. And as for as good as Bowles is defensively on the inside, not fouling, there's not much you can do there. That joker right there coming at you with a full head of steam. You got one or two options. Just let her go completely or foul.
Yeah. Bowles goes for the ladder. First free throw. Good for Filoxi. Back in are number 30, Charlotte Lures, and number 3, Sahai Corby.
I like Corby's and Lures too. This is, like I said, just a team full of kids that know how to compete. Every single possession, you know, even a kid like Morgan, they're bringing in here, trying to just disrupt here on the press and trap. You see Beale get out right away. And that's what she brings you. You know, we talked about how do you replace a kid, you know, like Dana Evans spoke with Danny Riggle about it, and he said, you know, honestly, you can't replace that type of production. You know, a kid that's going to average 20 points inside of EYBL play. You can't get that from one person. We can't say, hey, I need you to come in and account for 60% of the offense. But I can ask you to account for 20% and then use your distributing ability to get the other 40% back from us. And that's exactly what you're seeing from Beeler here right now.
Free throw in and out, knocked out of bounds by Bowles. Kirsten Moore to throw it in.
Oh. Oh.
So, a little bit of contact there.
just a little. just again, it goes back to what we talked about, you know, the kids playing hard to the final buzzer, man, flying, really trying to make plays and make things happen.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense that the Indy Lady Gymrats played on Deanna Davis. You know, individually, not just with Beeler, but just as a core. Their guards really made it to where you had to go through Filoxi or Ripley to get a lot of production.
Yeah. Man, that's tough. He's like, even the last move there for Davis. Was able to get to the hole, but it was so hard that she was going a little bit faster than she wanted to be able to try to finish there. Well, it's interesting to see as July goes on, teams start to figure it out. You see teams' chemistry start to click, things like that. And I think both of these teams saw in this game, you know, a little bit of, you know, growth in that regard, you know, in terms of, you know, continuing to get better, Marcus, whether it's the Gym Rats or the Gauchos. Both teams got a little bit better today, sharpening the iron with this matchup.
Thanks for joining us here on SUV TV for day one, TSB Real Deal in the Ville. We'll catch you here tomorrow as well. Check out the website for the broadcast listings. Those will be posted later tonight. Thanks for watching.